Hi, I'm Olivia.
And I'm Brianna.
And this is NTV.
Episode 2.
No! This is NTV Fun House Edition!
Warning, this is not your average episode of NTV. Are you ready?
Hi, I'm Sabrina.
And I'm Vanessa, and this is a new segment we like to call
The Do's and Don'ts on How to Get a Valentine.
Hey Vanessa, so how are those college interviews going?
They're going good. They just asked me a few questions here and there. But
hi, how you doing, Vanessa? Am I too close to you? Is it like kind of close? No. Should I back up?
It's okay. It's okay.
You sure?
It's all right.
All right, good. I got a question. Quick question. Would you be my Valentine? Please. Please.
No.
You sure?
Yeah.
I'm good for that. I'm lonely. Please. No. Alright, okay. See you later.
Hey Vanessa, so how are those college interviews going?
They're going good. They just asked me a few questions here and there about...
What's up, Vanessa?
Hey,
Eric.
Good
question. Would you be my Valentine?
I would love to be a Valentine.
Hey. Take this.
I love the way your hair smells after P.E.
Would you do my Valentine?
No.
Please?
No.
Tomorrow?
No.
Next day?
No!
Okay. Hey Vanessa, would you be my Valentine?
Breaths. Hey! Get it done. Take this one. And this one. This one's open. Take it.
Ugh.
Hi Vanessa, would you be my Valentine?
I would love to be a Valentine, Eric.
Oh,
some of my strengths. Well, I made a lot of improvements to my game, mainly because of coaches. They kind of helped me throughout my whole basketball career, in a sense. They kind of helped me with my attitude and my skill set. Kind of shoot the ball pretty good, and I could slash pretty well. I could rebound, pass, mainly anything. Well, I motivate my teammates by like giving pep talks and always trying to stay positive. Say we're down in the game and everybody heads is down, I always try to make it like seem positive and say, oh, we can still get back in it. Don't give up, we can still do it, it don't matter. Like, gotta bat it out to the last seconds of the game. Can never give up. It's kind of challenging trying to balance everything together, schoolwork, keeping a high GPA, coming to practice. But like my coach right now, she's helping me work through it. So like, it'll better me in the future. I can offer college teams a lot, all off the court and on the court, because I'm a well-rounded student. And on the court,
I can be a role model and an impact player whenever the coach wants me to be.
Now it's time for some advisory questions. So take out a pen and piece of paper.
What has four eyes but can't see?
When I was a little boy, I chased chickens in my backyard, believing they were mean, vindictive leprechauns. Leprechauns are scary creatures, stealing what is important to us in our sleep, our dreams, our hopes, and they leave only our fears. Everyone knows. The rainbow is so close, yet so far. So one day, I trapped a chicken in my arms, hoping it would be the boss leprechaun. Gripping it tightly with my fearful hands, I wanted to question it, to tell it not to take my dreams away. I told it that my dreams were to become an astronaut. I wanted to study science, fly away to the stars, and leave this scary backyard forever. This one that had all the clucking, clacking leprechauns. I mean, chickens, forever. I was in a blurry and angry daze, holding this chicken, leprechaun, and it spoke back to me. Stupid boy, you are afraid of heights. You can't go into space. Even more enraged, I threw the chicken as far as I could by the wing, yelling, erstwhile, "What would you know, birdie? You can't even fly!" Up in the air it went, until it came crashing down with a thud and one final exasperated cluck. My mother rushed into the backyard, and after hearing the death thud, I started to cry. She looked at me, I at her. She smiled, saying, "Thanks for getting us dinner." That evening, I had my favorite part, the drumstick, thinking all the while to myself, "No leprechaun can speak to me like that." Many years passed since I had my last bad dream. Until that bully in the 12th grade, you know who he is, would become my next leprechaun. You don't want to know what happened to him. Now, I am my own leprechaun.
Now it's time for some advisory questions. So take out a pen and piece of paper.
Find three positive whole numbers that have the same answer added together or when multiplied together.
Do you find yourself sleeping in class? Are you having trouble staying awake? But are tired of teachers waking you up, asking you to do work? Well, we have some safe havens for you to sleep in. How about the auditorium? The classroom? The gymnasium? A random storage room? The girls' locker room? Let's not be sexist, the boys' locker room? Back to the girls' bathroom? And last but not least, the staircase!
Disclaimer. NTV is not responsible if you get caught. Getting caught may result in the danger of your cat, dog, bird, fish, old fish, new fish, red fish, blue fish. You'll be sentenced to life in the ball pit and serve your sentence as a servant of the Bunny Queen. You've been warned.
Where is Corpita? Hey, Brianna, what's up?
Nothing much. I'm looking for Mr. Colpita. I'm trying to be a good person and return his pen.
Oh, okay. Trying.
I'ma ignore that. Anyway, have you seen him?
No, but I mean, I can hunt you up for him. Mm-hmm. I can go ask some people. I'll be back.
Okay.
Later.
Bye.
Hey, BT.
Hi.
Have you seen Mr. Colpita?
I think he's in the teacher center.
Hey, Brianna, is Mr. Colpita in the teacher center?
Nope, not in here.
Well, looks like Mr. Colpita wasn't there. Let's keep looking. Hey, Ivana.
Hey.
I was wondering, how do you happen to see where Mr. Colpita went? We're looking for him.
It's maybe unlikely, but have you checked his room?
Okay, rude. So, Brianna, is he in his room?
Nope.
Okay, so he's not in there. Let's go find someone else, shall we? Oh, hey, Miss Reed. Hey, do you know where Mr. Colpita is?
Just get him out of there.
Wait, what? Hey, Brianna.
I ain't sign up for this.
Brianna? Wait, Mr. Korea, wait, where are you going? I guess we'll see you guys in the next episode of Where's Corpita?
Now it's time for some advisory questions, so take out a pen and piece of paper. As an advisory, create a written skit with a theme. Submit it to Ms. Goldenbaum, and the best skit will be performed and aired on the next NTV episode.
Hi, I'm Kenneth.
And I'm Kaylin.
And it's time for the teacher shootout. You selected two of our favorite teachers here at Northside to compete in a shootout.
We chose Mr. Lunar and Ms. Gambino. Last week, we went into advisory to ask who you think would win.
Here are the results.
Well, it looks like the anticipation is pretty high, so let's get to it.
Let the games begin.
Years later.
It feels pretty good. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little nervous right now.
I have full faith in you, Miss.
Oh, it's okay. Well, I do have to say I couldn't have done it without the advice of a few students.
You're welcome.
Janet, Kaylin.
Okay.
Great. And Tisha, Tyreek, and Keon. Yeah, all together they told me to aim my elbow, flick the wrist, and it's from the legs, and don't worry.
Yep, so you did a wonderful
Thank
job.
You.
Congratulations.
Yay!
Congratulations.
Are you ready for the answers? Mississippi has four eyes we can't see. Three positive whole numbers that have the same product and sum are 1, 2, and 3.